All right, welcome back. Just before the break, we were talking about wheat prices. Pete, before we move on to talk about SAF, is the action in the wheat market, is it having any impact on corn?
I think it's an underlying support factor for corn. I mean, certainly beans look awful. You know, we talked a little bit earlier about the acreage as well. If wheat continues to go up and pull corn with it, you know, then a bigger case for us having more, a million or two more corn acres by the time we get to June 30th.
Well, looking at the demand front, on Thursday, UK imposing a 10% SAF requirement by 2030. That's in addition to the EU's 6% requirement by 2030. Pete, break it all down for us. What does this mean?
Domestic airlines in the U.S. already have a 10% soft target of 10% of their fuel coming from sustainable aviation fuel by 2030. But the U.K. now has made that a government mandate. The difference between the U.K. And the U.S. is that the U.S. is talking or we're waiting for confirmation of the 45Z tax credit. So there will be some money coming to SAF production. In the U.K., it's not. In the U.K., it's void of any sort of tax credit. So they're going to have to get there somehow. They will likely get there not the way that the U.S. is going to get there. The U.S. is going to get there via the alcohol to jet equation, but they're going to have to get there. So 10% by 2030 is the same mandate that, or it's the same goal that United has, Southwest has, Delta has. So yeah, when you add that though, 6%, EU is 6% by 2030. You know, the headlines just keep coming.
Yeah, well, one of those headlines is we saw the first cargo of sugar-based ethanol show up at the plant in Georgia. When we look at the SAF, when we look at that landscape here in the U.S., you know, can we do it with mandates? Or, Craig, do you think we do need some help from the government when it comes to tax credits? Is that how we're going to make SAF work?
Well, I think depending on how quickly you want it to happen, I think you can make the argument that we need the tax incentives and the tax support. And Pete and I have had conversations about this, that, you know, it's unfortunate that it seems that we can never have anything organic in this country. We have to have massive laws, massive subsidies, tax incentives. Nothing can kind of, you know, just happen organically. But that aside, yeah, if you want this to happen in the foreseeable future, you have to have the support there. Otherwise, I mean, I don't think these companies will make the investments that you're talking about. And not only that, but then you won't have the farmers on board with the sustainable practices that it's going to take. If they're not being incentivized to, you know, to change how we're all currently raising corn and need to, you know, to do it in a more sustainable way so that we check all the boxes. So yeah, I mean, I think if you want it to happen within this decade, you need the tax incentives, you need the structure there. Again, I just think it's too bad that nothing can kind of happen organically without the government passing massive legislation, a ton of bureaucracy involved, but that's the world we live in.
I'm with Craig 100% on this, right? We'd love to see it organically, but the fact of the matter is that there'll always be a green premium to sustainable aviation fuel. Sustainable aviation fuel at the moment is about 2.5 times the price of jet. And when you talk to the airlines have to be pragmatic about it, right? Whether you believe them or not, the airlines will tell you that they operate on razor thin margins. And the fact of the matter is fuel is about 25% of what it costs for them to fly a plane every day, right? So, you know, even Boeing, the sustainability officer at Boeing said this week at a conference in Rotterdam that, you know, you'll never see parity between Jet A and sustainable aviation fuel. Thus, here come the subsidies. I mean, the fact is, you know, Boeing has enough things on their plate rather than me commenting on the cost of sustainable aviation fuel, but I'll leave that for another time. But it's just, you know, you need these practices, or you need this money if you want to get to the goal of being carbon neutral by 2050, which is the goal of every U.S. airline at the moment.
Pete, Craig, thank you so much. We appreciate it. We need to take a quick break, and then we're checking in with Machinery Pete next.
Watch Markets Now with Michelle Rook on the Farm Journal YouTube channel, keeping you updated throughout the day on the markets at the open, midday, and close. Find out what moved the markets today and what to expect the market to do next.